Good morning, everyone. Thanks for coming to yoga today. If you can, we're going to be seated for a while. And if you are able, knees and otherwise, to sit up on one or two blocks, and your knees are okay with that. What I tend to do is I'll sit up on one, but it's up on that second level. For a lot of people, sitting up on two is really, really nice. And for others, no amount of blocks is going to make those knees feel good. So if that is the case for you, please sit in a different way, a way that makes your body happy. Not Shavasana, but sitting in a way that does not make you sit in pain. And if you are sitting this way, another thing to think about is if you are higher up, it's a lot easier on the ankles. And what they'll recommend is sometimes you can take like a little rolled washcloth and put it underneath the front of the ankle to help with that flatness, that straightness of the ankle. But often if you just come up a little higher on your blocks, that will do the trick as well. All right. So if you are sitting in this formation, it's kind of like a little hero pose. See if you can draw the inner ankles in toward the block. They may not touch, but if they do, just see if you can kind of draw them in as we stretch the fronts of the feet. And then lift up the shoulders really tall, roll them back and bring them down. And then just let the hands feel wherever they're comfortable. They might be here on the lap, or on your thighs. Just see where it feels good for you. And then even on this block, if you're sitting up on the block or if you're not, feel the tailbone just get heavy. I always have this vision of a fisherman's anchor weight, but not a big one. Just enough to draw the energy of the tailbone down toward the floor to create a little more space in the lower back. And then also feeling as if something were drawing straight up from the crown of the head up toward the ceiling or up toward the sky. And then find your breath. Good. Take a nice deep breath in. And exhale it out. And then I want you to do just a really simple counted breath here. As we inhale, you're going to count to the number one, and then exhaling two, inhaling three, all the way up to 10. And then you're going to reverse that and go from 10 back down to one. So inhaling your first count, number one, and exhaling two. And three, inhale. And four. And then continue on your own to 10, inhaling. Letting them be full inhale and exhales. And then once you reach 10, going from 10 back to 1. Stay with the focus of the breath and the count. Almost done. When you have finished that, just open the eyes and take a moment to see how something that simple makes you feel. It just brings it all back to center, helps you hopefully calm down, brings you into that parasympathetic nervous system that makes us feel so nice and cozy and warm and safe. All right. So if you've been sitting this way for a little while, take one foot out and just flex the ankle. Flex the foot and drop for two, just five of these, just to let your feet know they still have blood flow. Good. And then pause if you can stand it. Bring that foot back. Bring the other one forward. Oh, yeah. And lift. And two, that feels good. Three, four, and five. And then again, if you can, bring it on back. If this is getting really uncomfortable, come on out of that because we're going to move our attention to the hands. Last class I did feet, I think. Today we're going to play with the hands a little bit. So I want you to start by just having the fingers nice and soft. Don't even make fists, just soft fingers and curl your wrists. So you think about all the things we do with our hands, and we know, right? When we injure a finger, we really know how much we do. Good, switch directions. So we're just going to give them a little bit of love. In yoga, sometimes the wrists and the hands can take a little bit of a beating. Good. And then spread the fingers out wide and curl them in big fist and big wide and fist. And then open your fingers again, coming off of an article. Imagine those are like duck feet, right? And there's webbing in between each one of those fingers. And you want to spread that webbing really, really wide. And then pretend you're a bear and make some claws. I know, right? The things we come up with. Good. Spread them nice and wide and make finger claws and big and wide. Last one. And maybe a growl with this one. And then shake those out. Feel the wrist. Yeah. Good. And then you're going to bring all the fingers together like you're pinching something. Good. And then you're going to make fists with your thumbs on the outside. And then fingers together and fists and fingers together and fists and shake those out. Good. One hand only. Just pick one hand, touch thumb to pinky finger, thumb to ring to middle, excuse me, to index, and then go back and forth. Just one hand. Just go back and forth. Try not to look at your hand while you're doing that. Good, couple more. Next time you're at your pinky, pause and squeeze. And then ring finger squeeze, middle finger squeeze, index finger squeeze, and shake that hand out. Go to the other side, pinky, ring, middle, index. Just go back and forth. The lighting is very strange today. Good. Just keep it going. Something you shouldn't even have to think about. If you're watching TV, right, you could play here. Good coordination. Good. Next time you're at your pinky, pause and give it a good squeeze. And then next finger. And next finger. And last finger. And shake them out. Inhale, take the arms up. Exhale right down to your palms. Now, right now, the palms are all touching. I want you to drop the wrists until the palms separate, but the rack of knuckles and the fingers stay together. So drop and then release and squeeze it down, release. Three, good. Two more right here. And last one. Good. And then leave them so the palms are together and just separate your pinky fingers. Yep. And then put them back together and try to separate your ring fingers. Keep everything else together. Put those together. Middle fingers and together index fingers and thumbs. Good. Go backwards. So thumbs, index. Notice which ones are harder. Middle, ring. That one's tricky for me. And pinky and release. Nice job, everybody. Take those arms up. Exhale to your heart. Interlace. Press them out. Really, really press around the shoulders, but don't drop the head or the chest. And then pull the shoulders back and reach those palms up. And then see if you can move the thumbs closer to the ceiling or the pinkies further back. So we're working with that side wrist a little bit. Good. Bring them forward. Bring them back to chest. Good. Just one more here. Turn them out. Press. Draw the shoulders. Keep the torso nice and tall. We're almost done for the legs. And take them up and then try to flatten that palm a little bit more up toward the ceiling and release it down. Nice job, everybody. Shake it all out. And then come on up off your block. Take that block out of the way. Whoo! And come on down to a seat. Good. I hope you can see me because what I'm seeing on the screen is just this really faded out, like this half of my body's gone. It's just the lighting here today, I think. So inhale, take the arms up. Exhale, one hand down, other arm over. Good. And then that hand that's up high, make a nice fist and then curl that fist down toward your wrist. So making a little anchor there, right? Imagine that you've got, you're holding on to something over that head and just stretch that arm straight if you can. Take both arms up. Exhale the other side. Whew, good. Breathe. And then curl the fist, drop those knuckles down, stretch the back of those wrists. Find your breath, really stretch. Try not to bend the elbow and push up, everybody. Exhale, let go and roll that out. Good. And then hands in front of you. I want you to just see if you can lift your pinky fingers and your ring fingers and then your middle fingers. Index fingers and thumbs go the other way. So lift your thumbs. Remember, we did this with the toes. And down, index fingers, middle finger, ring finger. I laugh because other fingers want to join in, and pinky fingers. And then just kind of lean in front of those wrists a little bit. If it's okay, I want you to turn the fingers toward you. This one is harder. Please do not force this in any way. Just stretch the backs of those wrists. Keep the shoulders broad. And then peel your fingers off and shake it all out. Good job, everybody. Right? So, a little bit of finger love, especially when we're doing a lot of yoga. Give it a good rub and shake them off. All right, come on up to table pose. Always cushion those knees. Have your blocks at the front of your mat. You don't need them right now, so you can take hands off your blocks. Just find a little bit of a table pose here, but then drop down to your elbows and interlace the fingers in table pose, right? And then broaden through the shoulders and pretend you're going to push those elbows out to the sides. Press your right leg back. Lengthen the tailbone, lift the leg. Find your breath. So, a variation here of table pose. Breathe. And then notice where are you in the shoulders, right? Are you sinking down? Can you move your chest away from the floor and yet still keep everything fairly aligned? So, one, you're going to stay here. Two, you're going to plant your right hand to the mat. You're going to reach your left hand out forward. Still breathe. Good. Balancing table. Lift the left arm, right leg, left arm. You're on the elbow. I find these harder. Breathe. And then release and release that leg. And maybe press back into your hips just a little bit. Come on back up. Lower down to your elbows. Interlace the hands. Now, when you interlace the hands, look at your pinkies, your pinky fingers, and notice if you're just leaning on that bottom one. Take the bottom pinky out so that you're creating a little wider base there. And press the left leg back, lengthen the tailbone or tuck the belly and lift that leg. Press into the forearms. Find your breath. So, one, you're here. Two, you're going to unlace and plant the left hand. And reach the right hand forward. You're on your fingertips here so that you got some nice balance. You still have four, 3 points of contact, I guess. Breathe. Still okay. Lift that right arm. Press out of the left shoulder. Try not to sink. Find your breath, everybody. And release. Reinterlace or just flatten those hands and stretch back. Coming back to all fours, come back to your elbows. Interlace the hands, get that bottom pinky finger out of there so both pinkies are kind of stacked side by side, not one on top of the other. Plant your left hand, push into the left hand, take the right arm out to the side. Good. And then just bring it up any amount, it's not going to go far. And breathe. And take it down, eye of the needle, drop it down, and release that left arm so that you've got room to move that shoulder down to the floor. Deep breath, everybody. Bring the elbow back to the floor, push into that shoulder, lift the arm, and take it down. Other side, plant the right hand, right arm, take the left arm up. Exhale, little funky eye of the needle, and then extend the right arm so that you can get that left arm all the way down. Drop the right elbow, lift the left arm, and take it back to the floor. Press into both hands and just sit back for a second. Roll the shoulders. One more here, come on down. You're on your hands, just drop those elbows down to the floor and then press one leg out. Tone that belly in, lift the leg and pulse for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Easy, easy so far. Drop that right knee, extend the left, level in through the belly and pulse. 10, 9, 8, 7, little glute work. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower that knee and either walk the knees way back so you're in a half plank on your elbows or straighten the legs for half plank off the knees. Breathe, 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 or full plank if I said half. Full plank on elbows. Find your breath. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower the knees, lower the belly, and find just a really easy Sphinx pose. Just rock a little side to side. Ah. Nice job, everybody. And come back to center. Lower your whole torso. Press your hands on either side of your shoulders. Push into your knees to half plank, to full plank, to downward facing dog. Oh, good. Once you're in down dog, pedal it out, everybody. And then widen the feet. Shake your hips side to side. And then start to walk those hands back. Good. Bend the knees, hands to knees. Come on up and roll it out. Good. And then come on up, just a nice, easy pose. Shake it all out. And grab one of your blocks. We're going to come back to those blocks at the front, but I wanted to just stretch a little more through the arms first. I want you to take the blocks about the second width right between the feet. And bring the big toes and the inner ankles to that block. And just feel how I like this. I was playing with this morning. I like how this makes my legs feel like they're really solidly kind of hips width apart. Inhale, take the arms up. Exhale, the arms out to the sides. Internally rotate. I'll try to mirror here. Internally rotate your right arm or this side arm. Internal rotation. Bring that arm behind you until you feel that hand out to the other side. Take the other arm up and bend it. Now notice I'm not touching anything just yet because I want you to see how that feels, that shoulder rotation as we open up both shoulders, stretching the deltoid muscle and the tricep muscle. And breathe. Notice if that head is dropping down or the chin is tucking. And if it is, just bring it back. And then possibly, I'm going to see if I can walk with my block. Don't forget that block between your feet. I'm just going to see, will that hand start to walk up any amount? Will the fingers touch? Maybe they will, maybe they won't. I'm sure I've told this story before, but I never used to be able to touch my fingers. And then one day I could. And it was like, wow, isn't that different? That's all it is, right? It's different. So press the shoulders back, tone in through the belly, squeeze your cute little block between your feet, and breathe. And then that arm that's at the bottom, let it go again, let it come back out to your waist, and then slide it all the way down until it releases. Take the top arm up. And release that, shake them both out. Often, one side more challenging than the other. And I keep rubbing my elbow because I got stung by a wasp 4 days ago and it's still really itchy. And being on elbows just made it itchy again. All right, there you go. That's my life. Take the arms out and internally rotate the opposite, the other arm, right? So if I'm mirroring, that would be your left arm. And take it behind you all the way until that hand reaches your other side waist. And notice, right, you don't want to take that left shoulder back with it. Try to stay square and take the other arm up and just bend it and kind of pat yourself on the back. And notice, squeeze your block, by the way, don't forget about that. Find your breath here. That's it. Breathe, breathe. And then maybe slowly walk that arm up. Maybe it touches the other fingers, maybe not. So, this is my tighter side. My right arm is dominant. It's the one for me that's down, and it's always tighter on this side. And again, I used to not be able to touch fingers, and now I can. And that doesn't make me any better or worse a yogi. It's just my body has been able to stretch or move through that range of motion. So be where you are. Find your breath. Squeeze your block. Good. If your fingers are touching, let go. And then just slide that back hand down again. And then keep it close to the body. Slide it all the way off. And then lift the other one and shake that out. Hey, the light just changed. I don't know what just happened. Good. Inhale, take it up, squeeze your block. Exhale, soft knees, come on down. Nice forward fold here. If your fingers don't touch the floor, please take your hands to your shins. Find a nice stretch, but don't overreach this stretch, right? If you can imagine from the very back of your heel going all the way up the back of the legs, right from the center line of your feet. Ah, that's what we're stretching, everybody. And then bend your knees, hands come to knees, and come on up. Good. And then let's bring those blocks back to the front of your yoga mat and find mountain pose. Inhale, reach it up. Exhale, nice forward fold here. Take your hands to your blocks, peel your right foot off, step back into your lunge. In this lunge, your knee can be up or down. Your hands, your foot, and your hands are pretty much lined up. Draw the shoulders back and then take both hands into soft fists and press those knuckles into your blocks as if that were the only thing holding you up. So, a little bit of wrist work here, a little bit of hand work. Look at your arms, look at your wrists, and make sure they are straight up and down, straight up and down. They're not bending out or bending in. Breathe. And then just leave your right hand on your block Take your left hand off, unfist it, and reach the arm back. Good. Big deep breath, everybody. I still want you to put a bit of weight on that block if you can. And then both hands reach up, both hands unfurl, and you reach up into a nice strong lunge. Breathe. And then exhale all the way down. Hands come to your blocks. The blocks can walk forward a little bit, push off your back foot, bend both knees, come on up. Exhale to your heart and release it. Shake it out. Inhale, take it up. Exhale all the way down, all the way. Find your breath. Soften the knees and step back with your, shoot, I think it was your right leg, but now I bet it was your left leg. I always start with my right. That feels better. And breathe. Walk the blocks back if you need to. Lengthen your spine. Engage your little glute muscle and try to fire up that leg. Again, the knee can be down here. It's effective both ways. And then go to those soft fists again. Oh, yeah. Breathe, everybody. And then feel like you're really strong here, right? Back leg is active, front leg is aligned. The hands are pressing into the blocks. Leave the left hand where it is, release the right hand and reach it back. Good. Find that leg strength and then both arms reach up. Release the fingers. Find your breath. Breathe. And then exhale all the way down to the blocks, push off and step forward, bend both knees and come on up. Exhale to your heart, shake it out. Inhale, reach it up. Exhale, swan dive. Soften the knees, step back with your right leg. Turn your back foot to the side position. Take your left hand to your left knee. We're looking at warrior two, everybody. So press up. And sorry to have my back to you. Open up the shoulders. And then turn the palms up and bring them up toward the ceiling and touch palms if you can. And then exhale and take them back behind you and interlace. Good. One more. Take them up. See if hands can touch. Exhale behind. Interlace. Press it down. Open it up. Reach the feet away from each other. And then cartwheel back to your blocks. So inhale. Turn everything. Find your blocks. Push off and step forward. Bend the knees. Inhale all the way up. Exhale to your heart. You're getting it. Exhale, inhale, reach up. Exhale down. Peel the left foot, step it back. So, first, really, your distance for lunge and warrior two are usually about the same, pretty darn close. So, once you have your lunge, turn your back foot to the side position, right hand to the knee, push up, open up. Warrior two on this side. Firing up this back leg, toning in through the belly. And then inhale up, exhale behind. Interlace and press. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, interlace. Whoo, and breathe. And then take it out to warrior two. Cartwheel yourself all the way back. And push off to step forward. Bend the knees, come on up. Exhale, shake it out. Good. So, one more here, and that's chair pose. And then we're going to throw those all together. So, your feet are hips width apart, your torso is really tall. I want you to feel your feet, like, really get a sense of them, right? So, sometimes we can have neuropathy and changes and surgeries to the feet, and we forget to connect to them. Okay. So I really think about when I place my feet, where are my toes? Where are the four corners? What do I naturally do? Do I naturally curl in? Do I naturally press out? Can I find the four corners of the feet? And then imagine that power coming all the way up. Like, make yourself taller in your mind every day. You're taller, you're stronger, you have more stability. And then inhale, reach up. Exhale your hands to your heart. Come on down to a squat. If your chair feels terrible, I want you to change something. Often we drop too low and we stick our little butts out and we go into our low backs too much. And if that's the case, you know what to do, right? You lengthen the tailbone, you lift the chest, maybe you stand up a little bit more. So find your breath here, interlace your hands and press them out in front of you. And then see if you can take them up kind of at a diagonal above your head. Good. Big breath here, everybody. I know this is a tricky one. And then stand all the way up. Release, interlace behind. Inhale, take them up. Interlace, press up. Find a chair. Find a chair. Inhale all the way up. Exhale, interlace behind. If you have the presence of mind, interlace the other way that you usually do. And one more, take them up. Interlace and press. Exhale, squat. Breathe. Find that really solid chair pose. And then stand up. Exhale, take it behind. Try to interlace the other way. Stretch it out. And release it. Shake it out, everybody. All right, rub those hands. Take the backs of the hands together and kind of lift up and down. Stretch it out. All right, here we go. Front of your mat. Inhale, take it up. Exhale, swan dive to your blocks. Heel the right foot off the floor. Step back. Nice lunge, everybody. Nice lunge. Bring the blocks back toward your foot. If they're forward, come to those soft fists again and breathe. Press in. Keep the right one. So your left foot is forward. Keep your right fist where it is. Release the left one back. We've already been here. Nice tone to that low belly. When you're ready, sweep both arms up to a lunge. Aha. Breathe, everybody. Imagine you're holding a beach ball. Take your hands to your heart. Turn your back foot to the side position. Recheck the front knee. Don't let it roll in. Breathe, tone in through the belly. Open those arms. Find your breath. Curl your fists. Tuck your fingers and stretch those hands. And then inhale, touch palms. Exhale, reach behind and interlace. Inhale, touch your palms. Exhale, interlace. Whew, press it out. Nice job, everybody. Start to cartwheel back toward your block. Turn that back foot position. Step up. Squat. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, interlace. Press up. Find chair pose. Now, the straighter your arms, even if they're here, but the shoulders are pulled back, the more we work that tricep muscle. Breathe. Stand all the way up. Exhale, little squat. Breathe, listen up. Take those hands behind, interlace, pull the shoulders back. Good. That's it, everybody. Inhale, release everything. Stand up. Exhale, down we go. Got to do the other side. Peel the left foot. Step back. Make some fists. Fists of love. Breathe. And if you didn't quite get that, I said fists of love. Keep the left fist pressing into the mat. Take the right one back and open those fingers. And if they're feeling tight, just give them a little wiggle. And then reach them all up. Find the breath. Hands to heart. Transition. Turn the back foot to the side position. Open the arms. Warrior two, right? Yeah, baby. Right? Let's just breathe, everybody. Curl the fist, turn them down. Oh, yeah. Stretch the backs of those arms. And then open them up, take them up. Exhale them down. Interlace, press the shoulders back and down. Inhale, tap them. Exhale, bring them back. See if you can interlace another way. Breathe. And then take those arms out. Let's cartwheel back, hands to blocks. Go slow with those transitions. Step forward, nice squat, and then inhale, reach up. Exhale, interlace as you press up and come to squat. Chair pose. Make sure we're sitting back. Find your breath. Good. Inhale, stand all the way up. Exhale, little baby squat again. Breathe and then release. Take them behind you. Interlace, press back. Find your breath. Good. Release everything. Stand up. Exhale to your heart. Shake it out, my darlings, and let it go. Give your wrists a little curl. And wiggle your fingers like you're playing a piano really fast. Good. Shake it out. All right. So grab your blocks and go wide on your mat. So take the blocks to the side. Got a little itchy eye. Hang on. And then step wide and shake out your hips and find your breath. Right? That's just beautiful. Ah, good. And when you're ready, just inhale, reach up. Exhale, come on down. You can take your hands to your blocks if you would like. So, kind of important when we're doing a lot of these forward fold things or even chair pose is checking with the hip creases and seeing if your feet are even. If those hip creases are drawing back and maybe just ever so slightly internally rotating, right? And then just feel your body. If you don't need blocks here, you're welcome to set them aside and just use your hands on the floor. But once again, I want you to feel the feet. Spread them out nice and wide. And then take your, I'll mirror again here. Take your left hand to the center and come onto your fingertips and press up. And then take the right arm out to the side. So instead of taking it up like we usually do, I want you to internally rotate it and take it behind your back, just like we did before. So your hand's resting on the opposite side waist. And one, you're going to stay there, or two, you're going to walk that hand up your back again. Breathe. And then slide it down, let it slide right across the glutes and come back to the floor. Other side, fingertips. So when I say fingertips, it's very much on purpose because we're working with the hands. And so whether we're doing soft fists or fingertips, right? Think of that, little claw movement we did at the beginning. That's kind of what I'm looking for here is this little claw movement as we pull the fingers into the floor, take the opposite arm out to the side, internally rotate, and bring it behind you and breathe. Good, nice deep breath. Maybe walk it up your back some, maybe not. And slide it down, let it slide right across the hips. Take it down, heel toe in, bend the knees a bunch, and come on up to standing. Whew. Good. And then heel toe in enough so that you're back to hips width apart and give your hips, glutes a nice squeeze. Always these little resets, I like them a lot. And shake that out. All right, so we're gonna go wide again. We're going to hinge at the hips. We're going to come on down again, a blocks or no blocks, and we're going to find those fingertips. Walk your left fingertips toward the center a little bit more And take the right arm out, internally rotate it. We just did this. And take the hand behind. If you can or want to, walk that arm up and pull the right shoulder away from the floor. Now you're going to bend those knees, everybody. Squeeze your belly and try to push your back into your hand as you come up. Still squat, other hand behind. That's a funky squat. And come back to those hands touching or not. And maybe you're here with one hand down, one hand up. Don't force this. If your head's down here and your chest is down here, you're forcing it. Breathe, stand straight up. Careful here. Squeeze those legs in the belly. Come on down and see if you can find a forward fold with that position. Release the top arm, slide the bottom arm down to your hip and back to the floor. All right, my loves, here we go. Right hand, fingertips, press in, take the left arm out, internally rotate, bring that hand behind. Just think about where it is, what it's doing. If you want, walk it up your back. Now, I'm thinking about my back or my chest, and I'm thinking about pushing it in, but I wouldn't come up like this with straight legs. I'm going to bend my legs, sit my hips and back. So I've got some power here to reach that arm up and take it behind and see. So my knees are still bent. You can deepen that squat bend if you want. Open up the chest. Yay! Right, tricep and deltoids. Having a good time. And breathe, everybody. All right, here's the tricky part. You're going to bring the butt forward. You're going to see if you want to play with a forward fold in this position. Release the top arm. Just slide the bottom arm down to the floor. Woo, shake it out. Turn your toes out. Bend the knees nice and deep. Bring your hands to your knees and come on up. Whew, and step those legs together. And just circle one arm. Circle the other arm. Circle both arms. Good. And shake it out. How many of you felt that? Like right here, particularly on your dominant arm. It's usually where I feel that stretch the most. And we're always just really mindful, right, of what that means in our bodies. All right, so come on back to the front of your mat. You can have your blocks, by the way. Let me go ahead and grab them. Bring them up to the front of your mat. You can have them high or low or medium. Inhale, take it up. Exhale, float it down. Soften and step back, right leg. Here we are again. We're right back where we started. It's a Wednesday, hump day, everybody. So come to soft fist. Push down. Imagine if you could, and we're not going to do that, but imagine if you could do plank pose here. So it's that kind of energy or engagement, not just of the fingers, the wrists, but the forearms, the upper arms, and the shoulders. So that's where I want you to feel kind of the energy of this. And then leave the right hand, take the left arm back. We were here already. Inhale, take it all up. Find your breath, curl your fingers, curl your wrists, open the hands, spread the fingers. Wiggle them. Take your hands to your heart. Back foot to the side position, warrior two. Open it up. Find your breath. Inhale them up. Exhale, interlace behind. Inhale up, tap. Exhale behind. Interlace, press. Nice job, everybody. Cartwheel back. Find your breath, step forward, bend the knees, inhale up, hands to heart, interlace, press up as you squat. Little flow class today. Breathe. Stand all the way up. Exhale, come back to your chair. Straight arms if you can, even if they're straight, which is perfectly beautiful. Take those hands behind. Interlace another way. Press the shoulders. Feel your legs. Big deep breath. Inhale, stand up. Exhale all the way down, all the way, all the way. Move your blocks out of the way. Step back, right leg. Whoo. Step back, left leg, downward facing dog. What? Plank pose, listen up. Lower your knees, elbows, interlace, pinky finger out of the way. Lift the knees. Find your breath. Five, four, three, two, one. Listen up. I know it's Wednesday. We gotta push through. Left hand to your mat. Push. Right hand to your mat. Plank pose. Down dog. What's got into her today? Find your breath, everyone. Step forward, left leg. Step forward, right leg. Whew. Bring those blocks back into place since you're down there and take it up. Exhale to your heart. Release and shake it out and go, no more tea for her. No. I switched from coffee to tea, so you can't blame it on coffee anymore. But all right, rub the hands, shake them out. Last one. Last one. Here we go, loves. Inhale, take it up. Exhale, forward fold. Just breathe. You know everything here is optional. You know you can take a little break if need be. All right, peel that left foot, step back. Nice strong pose. Take your hands to fists one more time and breathe. Leave your left hand where it is. Take the right one back. Engage the legs. Feel that back leg as powerful as the front leg. And then sweep both arms up. Hold on to the beach ball, everybody. Breathe. Take your hands to your heart. Turn your back foot to the side position. Check your front knee. You know who you are. Take the arms out and breathe. Good, nice tone to the belly. And then hands up, hands back, interlace, press it back. Inhale, tap up. Exhale, whoo, reach them back. And just feel how strong your body is, right? And sometimes we just have to find our strength, and sometimes we don't need to go there at all, right? No kidding. All right. Release arms out. Cartwheel back. Straighten out your back foot. Step forward. Nice bend to the knees. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, interlace. Maybe you interlace the other way and come on down. Breathe. Stand all the way up. Exhale, bend the knees again. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Exhale, take them behind. Interlace the other way. That's getting easier every time. Find that chair pose. Breathe. Stand everything up. Exhale all the way down. Move your blocks out of the way. Step back, left foot. Right foot to down dog. Pedal it out. Plank pose. Optional one, you're dropping the knees, dropping the elbows. Second option, drop one elbow, drop the other elbow. Find that plank pose. On elbows, knees up, knees down. You are good either way. Breathe. Five, four, three, two, one. Drop the knees. Come on down to your bellies. And let it go for a moment. Boy, did that feel good. I hope you agree. She's crazy, I tell you. Good. So lengthen your sit bones, lengthen your tailbone, little tone to the belly. Keep the upper body right where it is. Lift your left leg, press your right leg down. So, doing all the squats and things, even though we did a lot of upper body, all the squats and things, right? They do tighten the quads and the psoas. A little stretch here and lower down. Press down through the left foot, reach and lift the right foot or right leg. Find your breath and lower down. Take both feet wide on your mat. We're going to start with an easy or Sphinx pose. So come on up to Sphinx. Now, some of you, especially one of you that I'm thinking about at the moment, low back stuff is really tricky. So maybe you take, oh, the light changed again. Maybe you take your blanket and put that underneath your hips. It's so funny. I don't know why it's doing that. But so that your back bend isn't quite so deep. And then turn your palms face up. In Sphinx pose, turn the palms face up. Curl your fingers and curl your wrists. And then keep the fingers curled up, but then release and pull, release and curl, right? So all we're doing is a little forearm work here. Imagine if you had a couple of 1 or 2 pound weights here, be about the same thing. So curl and release. Good. Last one. Curl and release. Turn those palms face down. Hone in through the belly, press into your hands, and see if you can straighten the arms. So this is a very funky variation of cobra pose. Normally our hands would be closer to the shoulders. So just feel that, see if you can straighten the arms. And then walk the fingers forward a little bit more, tap the elbows. Let's do 20. So tap, two. When you lift straight, three. Four, if you can. Five, six, seven. Yep, straight arms, tricep. Nine, 10 more, everyone. Come on, 10, nine, eight. You know how persnickety those triceps are. Six, five, four, three. Come on, straight arms. Two, and one. And lower, hallelujah. Good, bend the knees and windshield wiper. And we're still faded out to white there. So this is going to be one heck of a recording. And lower the legs. We're going to do one more thing here. So I want you once again to lengthen through the lower back. Take those hands out to your sides. Bend the elbows and come up to fingertips. It's kind of like a little spidery thing, right? The elbows are pointing up, the fingertips are down, the pubic bone is down. See if you can lift up on those fingertips and then lower down and lift up and lower down. Good. Three more. Push up on the fingers and down. And four and down. Last one, push up and down. Holy moly. And then just roll over to one side and come on to your back. I don't know what in the world to think of this light, but I might fuss. Okay, now it's changed. Like it can't stay focused for some reason. Good. So come on to your backs, everybody. All the way down. Oh, your feet are on the floor. Just pause. Take the arms out to T position and with the palms face up. And just breathe. So, in this position, I want you to lift the arms off the floor just enough to spread the fingers like we did at the beginning of class. Think of that webbing in between, like little duck's feet, and you want to spread that webbing out as much as you can. And then, claw hands, right? Little bear hands, claw them in. And then spread, keep the shoulders on the floor and claw hands. And then take the arms up in front of you. The shoulders are down on the floor. I want you to bring the fingers together like we did before, little like duck's bills or something. And then fists with the thumbs on the outside. Bring them together and thumbs to the side. One more, bring the hands together, fingers and hands, fists, thumbs on the side. Drop the shoulders, take the hands out of your field of vision or close your eyes. And then both hands, pinky to thumb, ring, middle, index, and go back and forth. So no visual cue of the hands. Breathe. And one more full round. And then press the pinkies together. Press the middle or the ring finger together. Press the middle fingers, the index fingers. Take the arms up to the ceiling, interlace, bring them up. And then, if it's okay for your shoulders, let those arms go overhead. Any amount. If you're holding on to it, like if your hands don't reach the floor, maybe you put them up on a blanket or a block just so your shoulders don't feel strained. Good. Breathe, everybody. And then take those arms right back up, release, and take them down. Take your feet nice and wide on the mat. Your arms can come back out to T position and drop the knees to one side. And then bring them up, go to the other side. Bring it back to center. And then draw your left, keep your right foot on the floor. Draw your left knee to your chest. Take the hands behind your left knee and straighten it up to the ceiling. And then point and flex your foot. Just a little point, flex. And then bend your knee. You're either going to grab your shin behind the knee, your shin, or your big toe with your peace fingers. And you're going to straighten the leg. As much as you can. Now, you don't have to hold your foot. You can hold that shin. You can hold at the knee, right? So honor that process. The left leg nice and straight if you can. And then only if you want, straighten the right leg. So hand to big toe pose, hand to big toe pose. Breathe. Just soften. Let the shoulder be heavy. My left shoulder is off the floor, but it's heavy. It's not straining. It's not reaching, overly reaching. It just feels really comfortable. Good. Breathe, everybody. And then bend the left knee, bring it to chest. Release it all the way straight. And then bend both knees, bring your right knee to your chest. Kind of level off and square those hips. Take the hands behind your right knee, straighten it up. And point and flex and point. Good. Flex. One more. Nice point and nice flex. Good. And then either you're right here or you're going to grab a hold of that shin. Or you're going to grab a hold of that big toe with your peace fingers and paws. Right, again, for me, this side's tighter. So it's like, oh yeah, I feel quite a difference in the stretch on this side. I'm going to try to keep those hips level. I'm going to give it a few breaths before I try to straighten the left leg. Good, breathe. And then only if you want, straighten the left leg. Don't straighten the left leg if it really changes your pose, right? If the pose gets kind of wonky, then I would go halfway and see how that feels. Deep breath. Let the right shoulder be super heavy. Maybe close the eyes. Maybe say a little thank you to these hands that work so hard for us all the time. Good, bend that knee. And straighten the leg all the way so you can feel both sides. And then bend both knees, shift your hips to the left, bring your knees to your chest, that gets you out of your low back, and lower the knees to the right. Let's open up that whole left side arm really nicely here. You can even take it up at a diagonal to stretch through the chest a little bit more. Notice if you're hiking up on your chin, keep it level. Deep breath. Relax your hand. Relax your arm. Don't overreach. Bring the top knee up and the bottom knee, feet to the floor, your hips come back to center, release that left side, and then shift your hips all the way to the right. Bring the knees up, allow them to lower to the left. The right arm goes up, maybe it goes at a little diagonal if that feels good. The face softens, the mind quiets down. Maybe we smile just a little bit, just to know that we showed up today and that we did what we could do in our own space, our own time. We shared a part of this community. Good. One more deep breath. Exhale it all the way out. Bring the top knee up and then the bottom. Feet to the floor, hips to center. Bring those knees to chest. Take both legs up and just wrap those arms around the backs of your legs. You can interlace those hands if you want. Gonna be a great day, everybody. And then let go of one leg and let it come down to the floor. Let go of the other leg, let it come down to the floor. And let's see if we can find Shavasana. Palms are face up. Shoulders are back. Your heart is wide open. Breathe. Soften down even more. You start to come out of your Shavasana, maybe smile. And start to wiggle the hands and the fingers, maybe circling your wrists. And then very slowly draw those knees up towards your chest. Rocking side to side. Allow the knees to come to one side or the other, curl all the way over to seedling pose. And then slowly press up, feeling those hands as if they were new for the first time. And then bring your hands to your heart. Bow to your own inner wisdom, inner goodness, inner love. Let that shine out, everybody. Namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you, everybody.